to ask for that, that the referendum ballot would be placed on the general election here in September, and let the people have their say. You know, it just seems like so often, you know, based on the past history, that the people have no voice in government anymore. Governments get elected, party leaders basically dictate the course of the province, and the people got to wait 4 years, you know, to take whatever falls on their lap. And we've got to get more of a direct democracy when it comes to these big issues like shale gas.
In some ways, is this not, it is in some ways, I guess, a referendum, because lines have been drawn, the Conservatives are moving ahead with it, Craig Leonard, their message is clear, and Brian Gilland has said they want to press pause and have a moratorium of some type on it. So I guess with those two parties anyway, it's a referendum, is it not?
Well, no, because I'll tell you why. First of all, for Brian Gilland to say we need to have a study to determine which way we should go is basically what he's saying. So that's very vague. There's no definitive answer there. Yes, we understand the Conservatives are going to proceed. But there are people out there that say, look, I like other Conservative policies and I vote Conservative,
right.
You know, but I don't want shale gas, so I vote against it, or vice versa. People may say, I like the Green Party, but I want shale gas, so I'll vote in favor of it. So it's, you know, it needs to be more definitive and, you know, kind of take the shadiness out of it so that people have that direct say on the course of their province in terms of the shale gas file.
How about the forestry plan? This is something that's been debated heavily. What do you think of the recent forestry plan, Irving, Crown Land, the whole bit, that file? What are your thoughts?
Well, look, we have concerns with that as well. And our biggest concern is just the secrecy of it. You know, government goes on and says how, you know, they've got scientists that back this up. And all we're saying, well, that's great. Show us. Show us the science. Show us what brought you to this conclusion that it's okay to increase by over 20% the Crown lands. Show us how private woodlot owners are not going to be affected, because let's face it, the more Crown land we give to industry, the more we cut the throats of private woodlot owners. Mm-hmm. So they need a stake in this as well, and they've been left out of the process for way too long. There's 41,000 of them in New Brunswick, and they deserve a fair shake.
What is your main plan of attack when it comes to bleeding youth to Western Canada? And not only youth, but a lot of people out there having to make a living can't do it here. It all comes back to the economy, does it not?
Yeah, it does. There's no question, Todd, this election is going to be about the economy. It's going to be about jobs. As a party, we said before, and I'll say it again, there is no magic bullet. I mean, there's no one thing that's going to turn it around. I think it's going to be a combination of things. Now, as a party, what we've been saying is we have to stop the corporate welfare in New Brunswick. We just seem to continually bail out failing businesses only to fail again years later, and then, you know, we sink further in debt. We've got to change the atmosphere, focus on small, medium-sized businesses, and try to give some incentive for entrepreneurs out there that want to get off the ground, university students that come out of school or community college students that come out with diplomas, that want to get their business started here in New Brunswick. Let's find ways to deregulate and provide, you know, incentive for them to do that here at home.
Chris, I wish we had more time, but we're just tight on time. I do appreciate it, and we'll chat again, and good luck.
Sounds good, Todd. Thanks so much.
All right, take care. That's People's Alliance Party Leader Chris Austin. When we come back, there's a call for independence for public health officers. We'll be back.